Hey, what's up guys? And today I'm gonna be giving you part 3 of Naruto, The God of Shinobi. Get this one to 100 likes as usual. Remember to share it to all of your friends on your social media platform. And I'm going to be posting 2 other what ifs on my main channel. I'll be leaving the link in top of description, so remember to check them out. They're gonna be out a couple of hours after this, so go over there and turn on that bell notification to stay posted. So yeah, remember to share to all your friends on your social media platform, turn on that bell notification stay posted, and let's get straight into it. Start the intro. So to do a little bit of recap, news has spread around all of the Shinobi nations that the Kyuubi of Konoha had gone missing. Tsunade was in pure anger when she heard the news, as she tells Tsujune to go and find Jiraiya right now. Meanwhile, the darkness inside of Naruto's heart had formed a dark Naruto. All of the pain and the suffering he went through when he was a kid form a darkness in his heart. Even the Kyuubi is trying to influence Naruto in a way, as he told Naruto that his mother was part of the Uzumaki clan, and the Uzumaki clan was betrayed by Konoha when the other villages team up and destroy the Uzumaki clan at Whirlpool. Somewhere underground, a woman, she was wearing a black cloak, and a man that was also wearing a black cloak. The woman killed 2 Root Anbus that Danzo sent to search for Naruto. This woman is also interested in finding Naruto. So basically that was the last part we left out, but you guys can go ahead and check it out for yourself and enjoy. So let's get straight into this part. Dark Naruto was talking to Naruto as he told him that his father is none other than Minato Namikaze. Naruto was speechless. He couldn't say a word. He didn't understand. Why would his father see the Kyuubi inside of him in the first place? To make everyone hate him as a child. To make him go through that horrible life. As Naruto looked at Dark Naruto, then he looked at Kurama. He didn't know what to say. When he was a little kid, he looked up to the 4th Hokage. But he never knew that he was his father. But now, he didn't know what to feel about him. His father was responsible for everything that bad happened to him through his whole life. I can tell that you're pretty confused right now. Well, no one can blame you. But there is nothing to be really confused about, Dark Naruto said. What the hell are you talking about? I just learned that my father was the Yondaime, and he was the one who sealed the Kyuubi inside of me. He messed up my entire childhood. What the hell am I not to be confused about? Naruto shouted. As Naruto started to scream to let out all of his frustration, as Dark Naruto started to smile from ear to ear, as he felt strong. Naruto was building a lot of hatred and a lot of darkness in his heart. And Dark Naruto was consuming it all. The screams lasted for a few more seconds. Then Naruto calmed down a little. Feeling better? Dark Naruto asked him. No, I just want to rip somebody apart right now. As the Kyuubi chuckled in his mind, that is how I feel all the damn time. Calm yourself down, Dark Naruto told him. As he wasn't ready to settle his plans yet, and Naruto was getting too angry, Naruto then started to calm himself as he took a deep breath. Naruto started to calm down. As he looked at Dark Naruto, are you okay now? Dark Naruto asked. No, I'm just calm, said Naruto. So, what are you going to do now? Dark Naruto asked. Konoha, Naruto mumbled. I once thought of that place my home. I thought that I had a bunch of friends there. I thought that I had enough time for people to recognize me. And now, said Naruto, as his eyes turned crimson, just like the Kyuubi, all I want to do is to destroy that place. They betray my clan, my mother and me, and my father. He said the title with disgust. He made my life a living hell, all to protect those damn idiots. I am making a promise right now that I won't stop until they pay for all they did. I will become strong enough to get revenge for my clan. That is a promise. Dark Naruto just smiled as he feel Naruto darkness increase in his heart, making his power increase as well. As he was very excited, as the Kyuubi was also happy, knowing that Naruto had pure hatred towards Konoha. Back at Konoha, Tsunade was beating the crap out of Jiraiya. What do you have to say for yourself? Please, have mercy. Wrong answer. Jiraiya continued to scream in a high tone pitch as Tsunade beat him for losing Naruto. Jiraiya had just arrived to Konoha after he had been told by a squad of Anbu that Tsunade has ordered his presence at once. Jiraiya was scared all the way back to Konoha, knowing that he will suffer a lot for losing Naruto. After a few more minutes of Jiraiya getting the crap beat out of him, Tsunade calmed down enough to talk. Jiraiya, you better hope he's alright, or else I will kill you. You hear me? She said with a dangerous glare as Jiraiya nodded, knowing that she was really angry. He had messed up big this time. With Sasuke. Sasuke just sighed as he walked back to his room at Orochimaru's hideout. He was walking to a room where Orochimaru and Kabuto and lots of other Sound Shinobi were in. The only thing he cared about is the strength to defeat Itachi at this moment, but something else was occupying his mind. His old teammate, Naruto. Where have you gone, dope? Sasuke said. Sasuke had just found out from Orochimaru and Kabuto that Naruto had snuck off with his training with Jiraiya, and now he's lost, but it has been a year since anyone see him. But it didn't make sense to him. Why would he leave? Naruto's dream is to become strong enough to become the Hokage, and the best way to do that is to train with a Sanin, right? As he reached the door, he opened it and went inside. As he closed it behind him, in the land of fire forest, two figures were traveling at high speeds. Would you slow down? The male screamed. If you can't keep up, then don't try to follow me, because I'm not slowing down, yelled the female back. Here I am, trying to help her, and what do I get? Screaming? That's all I get, the male complained. The female just ignored him, focusing on finding the last location which Naruto was seen at. Hey, you mind telling me why you're trying to find this kid? I know that he's Kushina's son, but still, asked the male. The female just looked back at him. I am trying to help him because I wasn't able to do so when I was younger. I know that I should have tried harder to get him out of that village, but certain circumstances made it impossible. But now, I will find him and protect him, and no one is going to stop me. I see. And you wouldn't have alternative motive to do this. Am I right? The male asks, as the female looked at him as her eye twitched. If you ever say that again, I will rip your arm off, she told him. Do you really think that I want to use him? I'm sorry, the male said as he raised up his hand in defense. The male shook his head silently. Of course he knew a lot about Uzumaki Naruto. Lot more than his partner did. But she didn't know that. Uzumaki Naruto, thought the male. Let's see if you are really the person that I was told about. As the both of them continue to dash through the trees. In a different location, a man screamed out. That was the scream of a fat man called Dan Hoshi. Hoshi was one of the most wantedest men in the elemental nations. He was known for kidnapping women and selling them in his slave corporation, and he was rich because of this. And he had maybe thousands of women at his disposal for his personal use. He also had a personal army of mercenaries and few rogue ninja among them. He was probably one of the fattest men in the world because of all the money he had. But right now, none of that mattered. You see, it was one of his regular nights as Hoshi was going to one of the clubs that he owned to have a couple of drinks with associates and friends and find a good woman from his selection and finish the day off. And that was it. But all that went down the drain when someone entered the club in a black cloak and started massacring everyone in the club. Even all the men that he called, the hundred of them, they were killed within minutes. Hoshi was afraid. He had never seen someone take down his army like that in a couple of minutes. As he ran out of the club and started running down the alley, but he stopped, realizing that he was at a dead end. No, I beg you, please don't kill me, he said. As he got on his knees, the figure said to him, you know, you're really fast for a fat man. Please, please don't kill me. I will pay you whatever you want. I'll double whatever you want, triple it. You think that I'm doing this for money? It was a man under the coat, he asked. Then I'll give you anything that you want. Land, power, woman, any of those. Please don't kill me. You are a fool. You people make me sick, the man said in a disgusted tone as he took out his sword from under the cloak. No, please. His pleas went unanswered as the figure do one swipe and sliced his head clean off. The head rolled down to the figure's feet as he looked down with his icy blue eyes and kicked away the head. Another voice then spoke, nice work, now burn the body to collect the bounty. As I said, I didn't do this for the money. Now there is one less person that women have to worry about. One less psychopath like him in the world. Whatever, brat. As the figure took off the hoodie to reveal that it was Naruto, as he picked up the head and put it inside of a bag, as he then sealed it in a sealing scroll, as he ran through hand signs and burned the body with his fire style jutsu. So about 3 months ago, Naruto has become a bounty / mercenary hunter. Thanks to all the bounty that he had acquired, he had millions in his personal account. This serves a lot of purpose. One, it get him used to killing, and two, it made him sharper in his stealth ability. And three, it helped him to be on the move faster. About 5 months ago, he noticed that someone was following him. He didn't know who it was, and he didn't want to find out. Naruto was now 15 years old, almost 16. He was taller now, something that he was grateful for. He was about 6'3". His voice has also gotten deeper. At the moment, he was a now S-rank shinobi. His training was almost completed. Just a couple of things were left, like a summoning. He had detached himself from the toad contract, so he had no summoning at the moment. And he decided that having one would be a good advantage over his future of being a shinobi. I still don't know What summoning would be a good one though? Naruto thought as he walked towards the cash house, as he went to go and collect the money. Skipping to another location, Chidori! The sound of bird chirping can be heard as Sasuke smashed his favorite jutsu on a giant boulder. He smirked as he saw how the rock went into about 1,000 pieces as he felt his attack becoming even more stronger. Yes, Sasuke thought in happiness. Yes, my training is almost complete and then I will be able to kill Orochimaru. As Sasuke wasn't going to allow Orochimaru to take control of his body. After all, he still didn't experience the best part of being young. Sasuke couldn't wait to find a suitable woman to rebuild his clan. Contrary to popular belief, he has always been interested in the opposite sex. But not the ones that always surrounded him. None of the fangirls. He wants someone powerful so he could rebuild his clan and the Uchiha clan could stand powerful again. But he have to kill Itachi first. As he then turned and looked up, he then think about Naruto. Dope, you better have gone and gotten stronger and not getting yourself killed. You have been missing for so long now. Hope you're not dead, Sasuke thought, as he wanted a rematch with Naruto. Back with the cloaked man and the woman. Okay, this is crap. How long have we been tracking this kid for? And we still can't find him. Be a man and stop whining, will you? The female said to him. It has been 9 months since the unknown shinobis have been looking for Naruto and they still couldn't find him, no matter what they did. They found a trace of him, but it always led them nowhere, or he was always disappeared. This kid is truly a master in hiding himself and making his tracks disappear, the man said. As for his partner, she was focusing on anything that would lead them to Naruto. She didn't care about her partner at the moment. It has been a while since they have been looking for Naruto and they still couldn't find him. And none of them knew that Naruto had killed Hoshi the night before. Okay, someone was definitely here, said the female as she looked at the dry blood on the ground. Yeah, and someone was also killed here, the man retorted. You are really starting to irritate me, she said. As the man just sighed, he was tired of looking for Naruto. 9 months has passed and they still couldn't find the little brat. Come on, let's just follow this. And with that, they moved on street from street and out to the outskirts of the village. They then came into a building that they both recognized. It was one of the cash houses where you can bring in the bounties and call it the cash. The female looked around as she didn't say anything. If he was here, that could only mean that he was collecting for a bounty, which means that he was the one who probably was responsible for that blood out there. I would have never thought that you have it in you, Naruto, the female said as she closed her eyes. As she knew that Naruto was not a cold-blooded killer, what could have changed him? She wondered. The two of them reached a door, and the female knocked on the door, and some creepy guy with one eye opened it halfway. Can I help you? He said in a hard voice. Yes, we are looking for someone, the female said in a cheery voice. No, I will not give out any information. Now leave, the man said as he slammed the door. Ha ha ha. It seems that you have lost your feminism, the man said. You tried to seduce him and make him give you information, but it seems like he won't. She then got angry and kicked the door down, shocking the man on the other side. I said, we're looking for a boy. As she grabbed him by the throat, slinging him up in the wall. Now, that wasn't very nice. I told you that I'm looking for someone, and you slammed the door in my face as she pulled out her sword. Back at Konoha, Sakura couldn't believe what had happened in the last 2 years. They were gone. her teammates, both of them are gone. Why? That was the only thing she could ask herself. Why would they leave her behind? Especially Naruto. He was the one that surprised her the most. Wasn't his dream to become Hokage? So why? Why did he leave the village? What happened to him? And why is he not coming back? And Sasuke. She kinda understood why he left. For revenge. To get stronger. So he could rebuild back his clan. But she was all alone. Team 7 was no more. She has begun training with Tsunade. The only thing she wants right now is to get her teammates back and get stronger to catch up to the two of them, no matter what. With the Akatsuki, Itachi could not believe what he's hearing. Are you sure about this, Zetsu? Pain asks. The Kyuubi Jinchūriki has become more powerful than we have ever anticipated. Zetsu told them all. Right now, he could probably rival Itachi. Itachi just kept silent. But his partner Kisame spoke up. That is impossible. We met the brat 2 years ago and he was just a weak pathetic kid. There is no way he could have gotten so strong over the 2 year gap. Kisame scoffed at that information. Are you doubting my skills of gathering information? Zetsu asked Kisame. What if I am? There is nothing you can do about it. After all, I am stronger than you. But guys, I'm gonna end this episode right here. You already know what to do. Like, subscribe, comment down below, and turn on that bell notification to stay posted. Remember to share this to all of your friends on your social media platform. And go ahead and check out my main channel, Anime King 2, where I'll be leaving a link in the description for you guys to enjoy. But for now, I'm out. Peace.